Pham, and Pham Winnie, was born in Vietnam shortly after the end of the Vietnam War. Her family escaped from Vietnam in 1980 and settled in Boston, Massachusetts in 1981. Winnie attended MIT and Boston College, and she had a triple major, kind of smart, through philosophy, communications, and pre-law. After she graduated, she worked at a hedge fund on Wall Street in New York City. She moved to Hawaii in 2009 and worked for several years at a Honolulu law firm. It happens that I had worked at that law firm, but we actually didn't know each other because our time at that law firm did not overlap. Since 2012, Winnie has worked at the United States District Court, where I work, and she serves as the Director of Human Resources. Her job at the federal court has nothing to do with having worked at the law firm where I worked. I didn't know her. She couldn't use me as a reference. She got hired because she had done excellent work, and people who knew her work praised her work. That's how she got her job. Now it happens, her office is right next door to my chambers. This is not good luck for her at all. I have lots of questions. I bother her constantly. If she bubbles, I don't hear it. She always answers. So it is my pleasure to introduce her.
Good morning. Thank you for providing me with this opportunity to be here with you. I'm truly honored to be standing here to celebrate with you today. My family has waited a long time to gain citizenship to this great country, much like you and your families. We've all had struggles, but we all stand here today with pride. 35 years ago, my family and I escaped Vietnam. It was 1980. It was year famine for our village. It was year famine for our village. I was merely a toddler at the time. One day, my dad secured us seats on a small boat. My mom and dad took me, and we had to depart immediately. My mom quickly packed rosary beads and a small statue of St. Mary. We had to leave so quickly that my parents never even had a proper chance to say goodbye to their own parents. My mom, nearly 22 at the time, I've never felt so many mixed emotions simultaneously. When we arrived at the boat dock, our little boat was jam-packed with 70 people. There was barely any space to stretch an arm or leg. Since we were lucky to be the last ones to be squeezed in, the boat left immediately. As we journeyed out to sea, my mom said that she didn't feel scared. She felt hopeful. Hopeful that a brighter future awaited us. However, the more days and nights we were stuck at sea, the more she started to lose hope. She had said that she had never felt so small as she did in the deep, dark ocean, looking up at the vast, bright sky. She was never sure we were ever going to make it. Yet there, in the middle of the deep, dark ocean, that hopeless hope was more hopeful than living in a country that didn't believe in hope. My dad always told me how lucky we were, even in the middle of the ocean. He said that God was looking over us, because in the days ahead, the ocean wasn't too turbulent. Thankfully, there were bouts of rain, which we survived on for lack of hydration. Sharks followed our boat, but everyone was too exhausted to let that even faze us. Those that died had to be thrown overboard to accommodate space. After 7 days and nights in the open seas, we miraculously landed in Malaysia. Upon seeing land, every survivor cried tears of astounding joy. When I climbed off the boat and landed ashore, my dad said I shivered and wobbled for hours. Here in Malaysia, we stayed for months at a refugee camp. it was here that my mom and dad sold their wedding rings to buy me 2 green apples because I was so hungry. I've never looked at green apples the same way again. After Malaysia, we got transferred to the Philippines, to another refugee camp. Every day, my dad would check the list for our names, praying and hoping for sponsorship. In November 1981, it is with the amazing grace of some great American citizens that we got sponsored to this remarkable country. I'm proud to call home. Homeless, but without the gracious lending hand of those that helped my family here, we wouldn't have survived. My mom said that the first time she received a small bag of donated used clothes for me, age 3 then, she broke down and cried because she was so astounded by that love and help. It's these small gestures that build our hearts in the biggest ways possible. Over the decades, my parents worked diligently to provide for their 4 kids. They opened several businesses in Boston to get employment for those in need. They gave back to the community tenfold. My dad taught me to never, ever give up on anything. 1 year ago, last September, my dad passed away from cancer at age 61. Even then, he fought to his last breath. The nurses told me they've never seen someone with such vigor and strength as much as my dad. Thank you so much, Dad, for everything you've done for me. I wish you could be here with us today as we celebrate this momentous occasion. You see, I've just wanted my entire family to understand college. I've paved my own path because my parents worked really hard to get me here. Never in my dreams would I have ever imagined that I would work in the federal courts, helping others get hired. Never in my dreams would I have ever imagined I'd be giving this speech to you and celebrating with each of you. I'm so incredibly happy to be here in this great country of green apples and green pastures. Each of you have journeyed your own path to get to this moment. You should be really proud of yourselves. I highly encourage all of you to pursue your dreams. I'm the prime example that dreams really come true here. Work really hard, climb up the ladder, and fortify your cultural contributions to this great nation. You are now vested with the power to shape the next chapter in U.S. history. Let's make it great together. Congratulations.